Smart Wargames here. I got the new command. It's finally released and I already checked it out for some minutes. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And yeah, I think it's already released for quite some hours. And I had a long day in real life, so I will do a first look, but I won't go into details of what is command and whatever. I think there should be by now there should be enough videos you can find on YouTube, Twitch, whatever. Again, give only my impressions, especially what is different. We will check out the new interface and probably the new options. I already have loaded a scenario and look at this. Look at how fluid is this. You immediately can tell the difference that they did a lot of work on this, and yeah, I've loaded Commonwealth Collision. That's in DLC because I want to launch some planes and to see it in 3D. And yeah, this fluidity, it's really awesome. Back then it wasn't a problem, you know. You could do with a right click, you could change focus point. And look at the map. I mean, now it looks cluttered. You think, man, a lot of names. You can change it, you can set, you disable the names, but now look, that's default. I don't have some map overlays loaded. Look at this. It takes some time. I'm not sure. I don't think the map is fetched from the local hard drive, because it would require a lot of space. I think they have something similar like Google Maps, that your information is fetched to your needs from the internet. So if you zoom into a map, it will get more detailed and take some time and probably get cached. So, and look at this, you already can tell the difference. Back then, the classic Shimano users, I think they used the ARC GIS provider, and even with, I like to use in almost all of my playthroughs, I used overlays of ARC GIS and a better resolution, but just of a limited area. But now, even that, you immediately can tell that's better than the overlays I used. It's quite detailed. Sometimes takes some time to load, but you can tell really the terrain details. Sure, it's now desert here, and some areas might be blurred out. It's similar to Google Maps, you know. There are because of secrecy and whatever and confidential, areas might be blurred out, because but not in this case. It simply took some time to load. Yeah, highway bridge, and I guess this is some sort of. And yeah, the detail is astounding. We can simply go to. Wait, what's. Is this a relief? No. Let's go to some urban area, and where you can really see the difference of the detail. And I love it. It's really, look at this. That's in detail I not even achieve this with my overlays, because most command scenarios play over a bigger area. So getting an overlay that is so detailed like this here would require a lot of a big overlay and a lot of processing time in order to create it. And now you don't need it anymore. Sure, you can create even more detailed overlays, really Google Maps style. It's still, you still have the option to load it if you want. For example, we are now at London. If you want really high detailed London for some, I don't know, anti-terror ops or whatever, you could do it. And there's even the, it looks like they added more map providers. Stamen, I think it's also a map provider. Let's load it, see what happens. And you see, you get a more a map that is in a fashion you would have on a map you may know from the military or whatever, without satellite imagery, but in a more map way, with street workouts layouts. And yeah, look at this, how detailed it is. Unbelievable, I hope. And if you can also combine them, let's disable the map but keep the roads and keep the normal layer, and you can combine them and look at this detail. Really good. And you have this for the complete world, and it's fluid. I mean, the Commonwealth Coalition isn't the biggest scenario. You could know the, I think the biggest scenario is a custom designed scenario, where you really can use this globe as some sort of for global warfare. I think it's China versus US or NATO in 2025, and you really can play war over the complete globe, and it's so fluid. Let's resume. We won't go into, I won't play it. I already checked it out. It looks like I can play continue my black gold blitz scenario in this new engine, but we will use this as an first look video. And yeah, check if there are also road networks. Okay, there are some road networks, and it helps simply to tell you what's going on the map. Back then, in the days without layouts, you simply had issues to tell where will units move. I really hope, I can't tell by now, we would have to play a new scenario, perhaps they release a new DLC. Somebody told me ground warfare is improved. Ground warfare was very abstracted. You could see the units firing, you could see explosions, but it was very, you know, a striker battalion was destroyed in, I don't know, 1 hour or something. In reality, this never would happen. And it would be interesting if they use road networks and stuff like this, and if they have less cover on a road. Yeah, I'm really interested if this map overlays of the streets, if they also translate into some gameplay differences. But it adds, the map got more realistic. I think the command map without overlays, it always had some anonymity, it had some big distance to what is happening. Simply had some mishmash of colors, yeah, and whatever. And this map, you look at this detail, you get a complete other impression of your AO. Yeah, and as you can see, the interface is completely different. They went for something similar. I did also with my Windows Blinds solution for some dark mode. Perhaps it can be changed. I'm not sure, I didn't check it out, but that's basically my sweet spot. And yeah, I might need to bring my pictures. I already checked it out. They have some pictures going on, but I think they amped up the picture game. Back Shimano, as you know, has a solution, and I that you have some pictures. They got they bought or purchased some picture packs, I don't know, from I guess some military picture providers, you know, like Google Pictures. There are also picture providers for military assets. However, if you imagine command models basically starting from post World War II, everything to future warfare, and all versions included, you might have, I don't know, 10,000, I can't, hard to guess, 10,000 of platforms in order to get all these pictures. It's A, perhaps impossible, B, because pictures have copyrights, and if you try to commercially sell a game, you need to get all pictures. And there was this sweet solution that the community provided a mod with a lot of pictures, and you can download it. I guess you still have to, can download it. I recommend it that you download it, and the folder structure is basically the same for the new command. You can install it. Simply don't overwrite pictures that are already there, because I think they even upped the picture quality. I can't tell right now, but it looks like they're using some high quality pictures. Perhaps they got an update on their picture provider also. But yeah, they, I think they added a lot of new platforms. I didn't have my picture mods installed. Over the course of years, I collected so many pictures for command. It's pretty easy, you know. You simply click this. You will see this number here, and then I think there are tutorials you can look up on YouTube. You simply look up picture. I don't know. It's I think JPEG, or it's the standard extension they use, and you simply look some picture on the internet, and then you name it aircraft-920. Put it in, and it will. You don't even have to restart your command, and it will up. It will fetch the picture. And I love pictures. It adds a lot of detail. Even with the 3D version, I like to have pictures for the personality. And I collected so many pictures over the years. From the community pack, but also from the. There was a guy on Steam. He made a big picture collection for Russian, Soviet, Turkish, and Syrian assets. I also have this, and over the course of several years, I collected so many pictures. So I will probably port them and simply don't press overwrite, so everything that is missing will get filled out. Yes, so this, and let's look at the right screen. One change I notice, at least from the technical standpoint, you still have your most of the buttons, but they of course don't have the Windows 98 look anymore. It's better organized, but one thing they added is that you have some quick control over your units, and I really welcome this. Perhaps it was already in the normal game, I can't tell, but I can't remember this. I like this. So if two units are in close proximity, and often this happened, I try to, and then you need to zoom in to find a unit. So if you have two units overlapping each other, you can select which one you want. It automatically shows. They got some good coders. I want to show you the new, you can immediately tell by the start menu. They got here some guys who know how to do some UIs. The only thing I'm missing here is resume game. I can't leave the screen anymore except from resume from autosave. Yeah, exit is exit the game. There's no button to return. So yeah, whatever, it perhaps it's auto saves automatically when you visit the screen. What you hear in the background is a new soundtrack. They got also a new soundtrack. You know, a lot of people, oh, soundtrack, what are you talking about? Not interesting. I love music, and music is also for wargaming extremely important for me. Back then in Shimano, you only have one track. Sure, you can load your playlist like I do, but I already listened into the tracks, and it's some professional work. It's really suiting the game. It's not some cheap, I don't know, royalty-free music quickly added, but it suits especially the modern. It has some modern feeling. It isn't intrusive. I might add it to my regular playlist. I like it. I'm running the music right now also through a playlist, because there are no volume controls in comment for the music. They might, it's not important, but yes. And I think this is new. If you select a unit, let's select a air unit. So MiG-29s flying, Indian MiG-29s, and you can immediately set the altitude and the speed. I like this because I often had to visit this F2 screen and to set the speed. And especially if you, you know, you can automate a lot, but sometimes you want, AI can't keep up with a human, not, and it will take perhaps not in the next decade. And especially the speed settings, you know, if you want to intercept somebody and the guy is already near bingo fuel, the AI will think, no, I won't go fast because otherwise I risk running out of fuel. And you say, no, fuck it, go fast. You don't need to press the F2 screen anymore. You can simply go here. I like it. Also for submarines, you know, the AI can't tell when it's appropriate, or can't tell that good like a human when it's appropriate to go over the layer, under the layer, because you as a player have to decide what is important: stay undetected, maximize your detection range. You know, it's impossible for AI to predict what a human commander is going for. So I like this also that you can simply quickly set this here. Sure, there are hotkeys, whatever, you can memorize them. It's also an old Shimano, but I like this. I like buttons on the screen. You can simply press. I don't need to think about hotkeys or whatever. Sometimes I like to play with hands off of the keyboard in a relaxed state, simply moving the mouse, and so you can have one hand free and relax and simply use a mouse, and you don't need hotkeys. For hotkeys, you need actively search the buttons and go on the I like this, that they added this. The rest is pretty same, pretty much the same. You have quick access controls to your sensors windows, your MCOM emission conditions settings, your doctrine. Most know what it is, but your doctrine setting and also your emission condition settings, weapon release authorization, WRR. It's basically your AI, ultimate AI control, your ultimate AI programming tool. I think it's command comes with one of the most powerful AI programming tools, not just in wargaming, but in games general. If you manage to understand this screen, and there are good Wikipedias, and I already checked out the manual, they did a lot of work on the manual, it's really good. And you can also learn a lot on the fly. If you understand the screen, it's the most powerful tool. You can set your AI whatever you want. You can turn them into suicide bombers, or you can turn them into extremely safe playing. I won't attack anything that I don't positively identify it as hostile. I will try to keep myself alive, whatever. You can, with this screen, you can basically achieve everything you're looking for. Like I said, sometimes, sure, if you want to have maximized positive result, you need to intervene as player versus AI. I already explained it. Yeah, it looks like it looks very similar. That's fine. AIP usage is probably new. I don't know it. AIP, for what stands it? Wait a second. Propulsion. Air independent propulsion, right? What is air independent propulsion? I know diesels, as everybody knows, diesels require air, often used to recharge electric batteries. Electric batteries are usually air independent. Nuclear is also air independent, and for example, German submarines use some new modern stuff, cell-based, which is also air-independent. You can see it as some sort of further development of the electric motor. But I think this is something different because the setting is interesting. Yes, when engaged offensive or engaged defensive. Because you're always running on battery when you are submerged and not snorkeling, aka not getting air into your submarine motors. So I think this is some sort... I know some stuff about submarine warfare, but I need to check out on this. It seems new, perhaps it was already in Simana, I didn't notice it. But it looks like a new technology or new addition to the engine. And yeah, you have this for every unit, but of course you can also set it globally for all your units and whatever. But I like this. Perhaps it was already in the original game, I'm not sure, but I didn't notice it. I like it. And especially this, let's check out. I often had the problem, I want to select airports. Yes! Exactly what I was looking for. And so, you know, you see me, if you want to select the airport, and nearby the airport there's a lot of anti-aircraft artillery, stuff that, bunkers, whatever, stuff that is located near airports. You often need to zoom in order to locate the real, actual airport. Now you can simply select this. Okay, that's the enemy. But for example here, you want to select your aircraft carrier, yeah, and you don't want to zoom in. It was always, oh, I need to select my aircraft carrier. I forget you can. Oh, that's... let me spend some seconds on this, man. That's so convenient. This fluidity, it's like going through, I don't know, through water, through butter, whatever. And aircraft carriers, yeah, you also had to zoom in because there are too many ships. Okay, they're using other symbols. They have new stylized symbols, I guess. More detailed ones. We will check out the map settings, but you don't want to zoom in. You press this and look at this. I want, for example, the planes on the Queen Elizabeth. You immediately have... it's got some really fancy pictures here going on. Yeah, because the Queen Elizabeth, back then when it released, it wasn't operational. And I like the colors. This green is really beautiful. And also the red, because my... but it looks really interesting, how similar it looks to the... Especially this screen here looks very similar to my... dark mode modification. Because this also is white. Perhaps they have some built-in Windows blinds. I'm not sure. I don't think so. But interesting. And they removed a lot of cluttering. You don't have millions of lines. This is good. I like this. This needs this form. Okay, this color is a bit. That's fine. Could be a bit brighter. Perhaps you can set it for your liking. So it's too dim. And yeah, let's launch some aircraft. The aircraft button was it's a bit small, but it's practice, you know. If you use it 1,000 times, it's fine. Let's launch all these guys. Let's check out every screen. Okay, business as usual. That's great. Launch individually. I want really, because I will show you soon the 3D view, so we want to have individual planes flying in air. Enable quick, what's that? Enable quick. What is this? is this aircraft carriers have the ability to keep some planes on a very high alert status. What this means basically is the pilots are already sitting in the planes, being nearby or already on the catapults, and they can launch immediately. You would like to have this, for example, for interceptors in a situation where danger arises for the aircraft carrier or nearby ally units. I'm not sure if this is... It changes the UI, but clutters it somehow. Perhaps it's just a filter for the UI. Okay. Oh, okay, they changed the loadout screen. It's more... Ooh, okay. That's it's more tidy. Yeah, you see the weapons still have no pictures, but no problem. Install the community pictures mod. Even the community pictures mod doesn't have everything, so you can collect on your own, or I don't know. But I like, I'm some sort of collecting pictures, even of weapon systems, because I like to have a visual of everything. Stingray, I know what this is for a weapon, but if you have a picture, you can, with some experience, you can immediately tell a lot of about the capability. You know, is it a really big missile or torpedo or whatever? Is it more a cruise missile or something intercepting aircraft? With some time you get a good eye for military hardware and can immediately tell what the stuff is for. And that's why I like pictures. Yeah, I will shift my pictures mod and... Did I explain it already? I'm not sure. And simply install the pictures and don't overwrite the old ones. And you have, because I think the old ones get heavily updated, and all free spaces are not, or aircraft that aren't covered by a picture will simply get a picture. Yeah, I think I already explained it, right? If a deja vu, how you add, but yeah, there are tutorials if I didn't, I think I did it already, how to add pictures. It's an extremely fast way and you don't need to reboot the game for it. So if you launch up a scenario, for example this one, and you want to fill out your pictures, of course it's not that easy for enemy platforms as you don't see them. But that's fine. You can do it quite fast. I can, in some minutes, I can complete pictures of everything. Okay, let's check out the menu. You see the, you still have the custom layer overlay for even more detailed layers or for specific military or map modes. And hide the shortcut bar. Okay. How can I... What the hell? It takes some time to load, I guess, yes. I like it, I guess. We will see if I use it or not. Looks like they shifted some... No, damage control is still here. So, you can decide whether to use this or this. I think a lot of informations are here and here, but yeah, I like it. Choice is always good. Record, play. That's it. What is this? Burn. Burn me. What is this? But can I manually decide what time I want? Five, and what's this? Ah, that's the fastest. Whoa, Jesus. Whoa, they added new sounds. Because some of the command sounds, they sound pretty old-fashioned, especially the missile launch one. I immediately replaced with a personal radar warning receiver sound. I think it was a launching plane, yes. And it sounded really good. It sounded really modern, good. But isn't there something between? I mean, why is my plus minus not working anymore? I need my plus minus shortcuts, because otherwise it's too difficult for me to set this. Space isn't working either. It's working. Space is working. Ah, it's now working. Okay, you have 1, 2, 5 and turbo. I mean, it's okay, it's fine. Most times you want to go fast, and I already spotted it here. You can advance time by a set amount of time. So let's do 1 minute. Will it work? Did it? Yeah, whatever. Perhaps it requires something. And I like this one. They got some filters for... I think it's way better. Like this. Yes, I love it. I love it. Yes, really important. Especially event messages. They have no tabs for the messages. We can see what happens if it detaches. We still have the option to detach it. But I think that's fine. That's too small, but that's too big. Can I? Yeah, we will detach it. It's too big for me. And that is no information for me. So we will detach it. And we'll see what happens. And yeah, stuff going on. Let's do the usual setting. Most times you won't do is show range symbols for selected unit. I mean, I love... Whoa, they look different. What does this mean? That's basically, I guess, the radar range of these units. No. Yes. I like to have a lot of stuff on maps, because it enables the brain more, and I like to have a lot of data and to filter on your own, to use your, I don't know, your own brain for filtering. But most players, I guess, if you have rage rings enabled for everything, it gets quite cluttered. So selected unit, and you still can decide for your own. If you need the information of this F-16 hostile, you press it and you get, I guess that's the radar range, and that's the range of when it would turn. But most planes have a forward-looking radar. And yeah, but we will find out. And here also the range rings. Okay, for submarine it's a bit more. That's the sonar. I need to get to find out the range rings, how exactly they are interpreted. Perhaps it has something to do with noise levels. But that's basically your sonar. Wait, no, it's too much. But 8 nautical miles, green was under what? Oh, okay, no, that's fine. That's underwater sensors. But obviously you can't detect enemy submarines on the range of what, 100 nautical miles. You never would detect. You see beneath the cursor, I will change it to display here. I don't like it on my cursor, this information about the map. I always have the information here. And you can, when you select a platform, there is an information. I can't show you because the cursor is attached to it. The information is attached to the cursor. It's 100 nautical miles away. I like this, that they always show you in relation to the selected platform. and you mic detect some dude, I don't know, listening hardcore music on his ghetto blaster and running his engines on full flank while hammering the hull. You might hear at this distance, but of course an enemy submarine you wouldn't hear, so I guess this range wings should help you to interpret. Exactly, yeah. Yeah, that's they changed the look of the reference points, that's okay. I will probably change them to smaller X's because they're too cluttering. And I like the music, really good job. There are five tracks, I think. This one, I like this one. This is really good. Getting me hyped. And yeah, okay, so we have speed controls. It looks like they over they dropped some of the speed settings, and I guess this setting is basically what your computer can run. And if you see, it's pretty fast. Okay, we have to select the map. I can't remember command being so fast and still so fluid. Look at this. It's really good. Normally it would. And the new sounds are great. I want to see what happens if we launch a missile, because this alarm sound was the most annoying sound in one of the most annoying sounds in video game history. Yes, but sure, you can replace it. Simply delete the sounds you don't like or replace them with something else. Okay. This quick bar we will check out later. Already shown you the start menu. Yeah, you can create a new blank scenario. You can play around in the editor and do some sandbox stuff. Load, I already told you we can load Black Gold Blitz. It seems it works, not sure, no limitations were spotted on the first guess, on the first glance. Okay, yeah, pan map. Okay, you have also hotkeys, not sure why. Okay, yeah, perhaps if you have no keyboard, if you have a touchpad or something. Okay, you would do on a touchpad. But if you have only a screen and a mouse, I guess you can do this stuff here. So even if your keyboard is blowing up, but even with a mouse you can do it. If you have a mouse only with one button, you can still control your command. Message lock in a separate window. Yes, that's better. Okay, I don't like the big... It's a bit big, guys. Can we... Switch to raw text view. Okay, they have the old one also in. Just don't like the big window header. It's also a bit from the look, the white is a bit, yeah, because it's again attached to Windows. But guys, I think you can do this. If you see this, please switch this to a slimmer one and dark, make it dark. It should be possible, because everything, the rest, I think, is still attached to Windows also, because this is not that beautiful. I mean, it takes too much space, this big thing here. You look, that's enough basically for me. And yeah, we will go into this. They added a new form of information display. No, it looks really ugly. Was the old one also so ugly? At least they all translated into the Windows blights. Yeah, damn it. So I need to go with the... message screen. Is my message log now completely gone or what? Where's my old message log? Where's the button? Okay. What happened to my message log? Okay, yeah. normally if you close the big one, I think the old one comes back, the built-in. Yeah, but I think you can, I see this, that it's still used, all you see here, I see it on the phones, it's still Windows-based, Windows interface-based, but with graphical modifications going on, please modify this also. If you do it like some mission, that okay, they all have this big bar. Yeah, whatever. That's fine for the time being. Yeah, sometimes I want to have raw text because otherwise you need to expand them, and they, you see, it, I think I like the filters, but if you're good with your eyes and you always check out the screen, you can also keep it in the old school mode. But if you look for something specific, this is of course really good. And now we will add view our, now get prepared. The 3D version is coming in. Yeah, I'm running right now, I'm running in trial mode of TechView Advanced. And hello, it's still loading, takes some time. Yeah, we're in. And I think the screen comes up because we are in trial mode, 21 days, it's fine. I will wait for a sale because TechView Advanced, it's not cheap, to be honest. But it's scalable, as you see. And I like it. I need to find a new home for the screen. I need some space because my mouse cursor, you see the information beneath my mouse cursor, will be displayed here. I think this. No, that's impossible. We need to take the left space. I need information, so I think this will become the new home. Especially with the new movement, it's quite easier to have even a bit cluttered, more cluttered screen, as you don't need to right-click anymore. And now we zoom in. And you already, yes, it's, see, there's already action going on. And look at these units there. That's an F35, and it looks like they really added most of the shapes in a correct form. Let's select the submarine. Yeah, one thing I wished for is, yeah, that's like an ad. I think if you buy it, however, I hope they will do a Christmas sale or something, so I will get it. But on Steam right now, I think you can also get for, or there's a bundle, I'm not sure if it's only on Steam, you can get it for 40% less if you buy both together. So you basically, what I would like to add, like to see added is, you don't need some hardcore ocean going on. This game works with an abstract graphics, and that's fine, but this looks like it's flying in air. Simply give this, you know, it should be possible that you add something like this water here, some darker tone when you are beneath the sea surface. Otherwise it looks a bit intrusive, especially because you still can't see the layer. And I'm wondering right now, is the submarine moving? It doesn't look like it. If you select a plane, it doesn't, perhaps the water isn't, I'm not sure. If I select this plane here, for example, it's in real time. You have stuff going on, yeah, his wingman flying with him, really great, I love it. Can go full screen. And we will simply send these guys, let's launch everything we have, and then we will send these guys simply into, and we'll do set the MCOM settings to engage everything, see what happens. Yeah, we might do it right now to check out. We are now checking out a 3D screen. So it's okay. Why is the screen not working? Yeah, because we have no land units, I guess. Yes, ignore plotted course. Engage everything in an optimistic way. Engage opportunity targets. Yes. Ignore emission conditions. Yes. You are free to engage everything. And use nuclear weapons. No, we don't have any. And radars go active. Music on. Sonars, keep them passive, otherwise the submarines will actively. But let's do it completely, come on, completely escalate. Here we don't need to set this ones. And we will launch everything we have. Okay. Yeah, look at this. Did they. How they. It can't be possible. Did they. At all shapes of all units. Let's check the unit and check this one. It looks okay. Wait, it looks different. No, it looks different. That's the tower. Second tower isn't that close. And perhaps they build it in a different way. Okay. But this guy looks, I know the, this looks very authentic. Did the guys from Command or from TechView added all shapes or what? That's really cool. Or most shapes. You don't have simply some abstraction of a ship, but you have actually the shape. I'm not sure if it's even possible that somebody could put some texture on it. Even if it looks low res, like, I don't know, comparable to Fleet Command, I'm pretty fine with this abstracted colors and textures. But imagine if this would be possible, that you could add some sort, at least of basic texture to it, some gray. It would give you really the Fleet Command vibes. And yeah, let's launch all planes of this guy too. Yeah, it would be really great if they could get this here. This is a bit out of place, the header of the windows. And I know, because by using Windows blinds, this can also be modified. Every app can modify the windows. We won't go into details, but it should be possible to make it. And yeah, slimmer is one option, but at least make it a bit darker. This white stripe, I think it's a bit intrusive. But it's only released today, so I guess these guys were. A lot of change will come. Okay, these guys are. There's a second platform. Who is carrying? Probably a destroyer carrying a helo. Yes, he's carrying a helo. Yeah, we don't need to launch every single aircraft. It's not that important. I only want to get. I like this setting. Whoever did this, genius. I mean, that's. I don't know many games that have this going on. Really good, because I so often had to click the airports and whatever. That's annoying. Yeah, that's the. Let's launch these guys also to get some really air action going on. Did we already launch the British ones? Are they have. Yeah, I think we have everything in air now. Okay. And yeah, resume, see what happens. Can also navigate this screen. One thing I'm already seeing and I don't like it. I hope they can get it fixed. Not sure if it's also for... Oh, Jesus. Oh, no. It is like I was afraid of. The problem I currently have. Not sure if I can change the setting. If you know, perhaps I need to go into the TechView application. If you know how I can change this, let me know. The problem right now in the standard settings is you gain a God view by using TechView. So, and you see, we see there is a submarine in front of us. We don't know about the submarine yet. But by using TechView, we basically cheated it. And even if you don't want to cheat, if you use this view, you would basically, by accident, see enemy units. You see, we can't see enemy aircraft units. We don't have intelligence right now in command. I'm not sure if this is basically hard-coded into TechView, but for me this is quite a huge limitation. To put it in a clear way, a fucking huge limitation. Let's assume we play this scenario and we want to get an overview, a 3D overview of our launching planes. Who wouldn't like to do this? And you check this out, how your airwing's launching, and by the way, you see, oh, okay, there's some dude sitting here. There's some red dot here. And you basically already know, okay, there's something in the water. Two submarines. A third submarine, oh, no, that's some surface ship. And yeah, it looks, of course, it looks beautiful, but it's goddamn cheating. Can we... And this is extremely limiting. I know TechView was designed for after action analysis, but I don't want to use it for after action. I'm not that interested into it. I never was interested into, I don't know, after I play my flag simulator to watch something in 3D, how people dogfight it with each other. And it wouldn't be that interesting for me to watch after action analysis reports of my command scenarios. I want to use it for real-time information in order to gain a better picture of the, and to get a third dimension, and simply for visual pleasure. And please tell me that you're working on this. Somebody tell me that the command guys or the TechView guys are working for a solution. Because this is... That's not going to happen. I can't play this way, you know, oh, let's do some 3D vision. Oh, okay, there's... And you can, even by this screen, I already see there and there are submarines. And that's it. That's cheating. And you will behave differently. You will behave differently. You see already they have some Scoutron going on. There are some F-16s in air. We don't have sensor data on these F-16s. There's some Squadron in air. Or that we did it. No, we don't. We don't have them detected. Ah, Jesus. Oh, is it a setting? Perhaps I'm raging around. It wasn't a rage. It was a suggestion. But as you see, there aren't much settings for TechView. Perhaps we need to go into TechView. Is it a TechView setting? But please work it out. That's extremely important. I'm not sure. But it should be somehow possible to tell the game, at least give me an option, a filter. For example, of course you want to see enemy planes also. I know where perhaps the problem is in programming terms. I think TechView would have difficulties to tell. You work a lot with ambiguous contacts because you don't know exactly where they are. How would TechView display them? For example, you know, there's a submarine, but the submarine could be in this area. Would be probably difficult for TechView to display this. It wasn't designed for this, at least for the moment being. I don't know, show me only enemy units that are confirmed, you know, in command. Confirmed units, they don't have this ambiguity boxes anymore, they get a fix. For example, this here is a fixed position you have information on, and show me this information on TechView. But don't show me a good eyes view, or at least let me set it. I know some guys want to do some analysis, whatever, that's fine. But for me, but for serious regular playthrough, perhaps there's a setting. If you know, let me know and we can simply switch this. Let's check the settings. But right now it looks for me it is a God view cheat. Ah, I like the stylized more. Okay. Okay, you still have the NTDS ones. I use this. I like them more than these big ones, as they also get. Yeah, they also get this vectors. I think these are the most beautiful ones. I like to use the official military ones, but sometimes not. And for this, especially because you are so working so much with the map, I like this ones the most. The directional ones, they are too big. I mean, for planes they look cool. But you know, all planes look like some Boeings. And the ships, yeah, okay, also cool. But I don't know, I like this more. Perhaps it's more similar to a Harpoon, I guess. I'm not sure. But yeah, whatever. And you again, for some reason, need to set scenario events. It's not on standard. I don't know why they don't turn scenario events on standard, so remember if you boot up the game to set this on. And you already noticed, and it's a really great addition, a really good idea. Can this goddamn disappear? Why is this? I mean, if you give me, oh, if you give me a trial, man, then stop. Perhaps it was, normally it disappears, I think. This info box that this is only in TechView Advanced. I think it's a safety measure to prevent that people buy the wrong TechView edition. It's fine. You know, somebody sees this and says, "Whoa, man, really cool," and goes and buys TechView Standard, and comes back and thinks, "Damn it, scammed." So I think they put some thought into it and added this information box, so people immediately know, okay, I need TechView Advanced. Because the free edition you can download is, there is no different edition, so it's a free version, free trial version. But yeah, thanks for sharing, I got it, thanks. Okay, yeah, well that's, it was about to disappear. Okay, I think it won't disappear. We have to face it. Goddamn box. What the hell? Yeah, I think. Okay. Yeah, set scenario events on because you want to know about it. But about the balloons. The balloons, you can, at the point of interest, where the incident is happening, you can show a balloon, and I really love it. For example, there are settings you want to know about, but you don't want to know too much about. A good example for me is a weapon is launched. If you disable completely the setting pop-up, you quickly lose situation awareness about weapons launched. And sometimes you want to know about weapons, for example, when the escalation is happening, And in other situations, when a big aerial battle is going on, the, where everybody is launching, I don't know, dozen of missiles, it might get tedious to always confirm the messages, to acknowledge them, And a balloon is a sweet middle solution. So if the battle would be going on here, there would a balloon rise, I don't know, AIM-RAM 120 launched. And that's really cool. I might experiment with it, especially for weapon launches. Please show me the attack view setting. What's this? Hover info. That's fancy. Vehicle information show. What vehicle information? Okay, we have no vehicles detected yet. But that's this beneath my mouse cursor, I guess. Right? So the... No. What is this? Hover information. Hover info settings. I guess this here. Yeah, there's something going on. Fuel information shows summary. However, I need to get rid of this from my mouse cursor. Here. Show on bottom. Yeah, way better. Okay. It's now here located. Do I like it more or less? Good. One good stuff is, of course, I have now more space, so I can do this. Yeah, it looks... Okay. Yeah, I'm fine with it. Reference point small. Yeah, that's better. If you select them, they... What the hell is this? Sometimes... What is this big box here? Okay, it's not gone. And yeah, that's fine. I don't need the big X's. Yeah, ghosted zone boys. Show ghosted group members when I select them. Show plotted paths all, that's fine. Message log is set, I guess. Yeah, show me message log, of course, and docking operations I want. Unit AI, I'm not sure what this is meaning. We might set it so I can see what happens. And weapon logic also, I think it's some deep, like, AIM-RAM 120 is going active and stuff like this. You couldn't also know about, really, so... Okay, it's again the same settings. I guess because it's performance related, ghosted group members also adds to the taxing. But the game is so quick, I don't know what they did. They did some serious... Look at this. I think people might go for bigger scenarios now, because this game looks a lot more fluid and resource efficient. What is hover info settings? Is it this here? Let's see if something happens. Did something happen? I don't see. Or do I need to keep it steady for some seconds? No. What is this hover info? Middle mouse button is not... It seems there is no middle mouse button, okay. I don't like it. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, hover information, I'm not sure what this is. Let's check aircraft. Weapon. View information show detailed. Nothing changed. Is it this perhaps? See if something happens. No. Vehicle information height. Did something happen? Whatever. We'll find it out. Yeah, like I said, two things. Perhaps when stuff is beneath the water, I get it. It's the first time for TechView modeling. I think TechView right now was only used for. But look, they have models for. That's really good. That's a kilo. I can tell immediately. And that's an Akula. Really good. And it's the first time for TechView, and I know this, but I know some different visualization for when you are beneath the water, at least some, that it doesn't look like you're clipping through the world or something, would be greater. Or yeah, I mean, they have a water layer, so something if you're beneath the water layer to make it more darker, so you can immediately tell you're beneath the water, below the water. And B, oh man, that's not good. But if we zoom in into our unit, the information disappears, so there must be an ability in the software to tell the software somehow, fade them out. Okay, so if we zoom close in a unit, we at least don't cheat. I mean, we can't get the utility of the tool is of course getting somewhat limited by this, but I'm fine. I can play like this. I don't want to cheat. And I love to see my unit. You still can see some air combat going on. Oh, goddamn, is this here? But no. Coast Guard Aviation. Who is this guy? He sees something he shouldn't see. Who is this Coast Guard Aviation? Yeah, that's this guy here. Okay, he isn't displayed, like identified. Perhaps the TechView can tell the difference. B2. Is B2 aircraft type? I don't mean it's, of course, not the bomber. B2 bomber. Babur helicopter. And we will now take a closer look at this. Let's make it bigger. Perhaps there is some identification going on. But look at this, for example, how we can know that there is a squadron right now in the air. We can't. This information here about this plane is not available right now if you look here. We have no information about this plane. So. Yeah, okay. I guess there's no model. There's no model for this Coast Guard guy. That's why he is displayed like an arrow. Because this guy here has a model. Yeah, I guess this one, this plane doesn't have a model, so he's displayed as an arrow. That's basically the placeholder. Yeah, the models are beautiful, but. It selects in-game also. That's cool. That's really good. Does it? No, it doesn't. I was thinking that if you select it here, it selects here also. or selected does it select only units we have detected? No. We know there's a guy coming, F-16. Where's the F-16? Here. No, okay. Yeah, we already know the F-16 is here at the coast. In reality, we don't know where it is. So let's again try to set something. Is it possible if I zoom in? Okay, about the Coast Guard, we know. It's a, that's fine, that's this guy here. And when we press on it, ah, shit. So if we press on enemy units, the tech view automatically shifts to them and we basically cheating. So we can't prevent it to know about the actual position. You see, that's the ambiguity box. These F-16s could be anywhere here. But if we press on it, on the central icon, it shows us the God view, tech view. And that's not what I want. Get this somehow fixed, that's really important. Yeah, we have information about vehicles, AI, okay, AA perhaps we have that, but yeah, no, that's not working. However, we will now set up mission area. We'll simply complete Pakistan and add a new mission. Ah, damn it, that's really... I hope they will somehow work further improve the 3D view, the tech view, and add some fog of war ability. That's extremely important. I think right now I can't, it's hard for me to tell really, because this feature was really big for me, but right now I can't use it in this way, because it's too, it's cheating. Yeah, go frenzy. Everybody is welcome. Okay, they removed the boxes. That's okay. I think the boxes were not needed because you can simply select single units. I mean, okay, for multi-selections, that's not possible anymore. But who is doing multi-selections? Almost nobody. Why is that preview always on top? That's also not needed. I don't like this. Is this always on top? Yeah, but no flag size and simply launch everybody. Everybody's, even helicopters, it's just for testing. Okay. Yeah, let's check it out again. Is this... No, that's not... Don't do this. I don't want this. I don't see utility in this. It's just cluttering. Is it for every screen? Yeah, why? Why? Why is this always on top? Not needed. Okay, the guy is coming. Looks like the lines look also better. I think they are different. They are more thin. I like always, that's the waypoints of the units. I like to have them, it gives me a better idea of what is going in what direction. Of course, now it's very cluttering, but normally you don't. Yeah, the new sounds are really cool. What? Hot? Go hot. Ah! Really good addition. really smart. The mission area has now the mission name. I often had trouble to tell the mission areas apart, especially if you have different similar missions going on. Really good, and it's perfect. I don't need to see it completely. I don't need to have it bright. It's perfect. I can say, okay, let's go hot mission area. And it looks like, even look at the AI, how quickly it is responding to the differences when I change the mission area. I see these waypoints jumping around because they're responding to the new space, and you can extremely fast move these points. I liked to play a lot, do a lot of command stuff by changing mission areas, and especially for my playstyle, this will be beautiful. Yeah, all planes are now going into full speed. We can see how it looks like. Oh man, I love this 3D screen. Please get somehow the fog of war fixed. And I think if it's not possible to do a really good solution, go in favor of... I mean, I love it, even that you can see everything here, sure, but it's cheating, you know. I mean, if we would play it, we already see what is coming for us, we would react. And that's not how warfare works. Disguise and secrecy are preventing detection is a big part of modern warfare. But I want to use the screen, look at this. Imagine you're launching your attack and then you can see these guys, you can even click them. Yeah, these Wildcats also going in. Look at this, beautiful. Adds a complete new layer to the game. But perhaps is there a setting? I mean, why are so... Isn't there more settings to it? I mean, TechView is running right now. Isn't there a control panel for TechView? I've closed the picture. Try it in order. Wait. Do we have underwater here now? I can't tell this. Okay, I can't zoom into the water. Like there is some interesting settings going on. I mean, underwater, high contrast. Yeah, high contrast looks... Hey, why the hell I don't have this high contrast here? I want a high contrast one. I mean... And look at this! There are filters, it looks like filters. Is there a hover? I mean, this TechView has a lot of great stuff going on. Why is this at objects? Okay. That's not helpful, but give me some options about the screen. Looks like this is TechView demo and this is 3D view. Or perhaps they want me to tell that I'm simply... Perhaps is the full version more if I have not a demo, do I have more utility, more settings? Can I tell this screen here to fetch this, the I guess not. Yeah, we will find it out, and I think they will work on it. I imagine that they know about that. This is very important. I think I'm not the only one. Okay, there's some action about to happen. We need to make this bigger. Let's make it complete Pakistan style. So the AI is completely automated basically. And we will see soon. I mean, okay. Minimap. Camera minimap. What's that? Camera following. Okay. Oh, does this work? Camera following. Following what? Minimap. Interesting. If it was, I heard it was requested for what? I mean, we have a big map. How do we need a minimap? Check it out. Ah, okay. This could, of course, enable some really big scenarios. You basically command is able to, yeah, to simulate global warfare to a detailed level. I think, sure, if there it, oh, clicked somewhere. Look at this transition, how quickly it goes. I mean, really good work. Scenario minimap. Okay. I mean, why not? I mean, it's helpful. No, it's helpful. Sometimes you get the tunnel vision on something, and you won't notice that something else is something. There is something going on. It's okay. It's for this scenario. Maybe you don't need it, but let's imagine we are also in war with Oman or whatever, and the states here, and somebody is coming here. We already detected them, but we not noticing because we are focusing on here. Yeah, switch the map city. Oh, really cool sounds here. Missiles launched. Aim ram. Man, I want to use the screen, please, but without this spot cheat. Map setting, only fire control. Evading, and we got a hit. What's this? Terrain. Is this for this map mode or? Okay. Thanks. Can I get rid of it? Right, what's going on? Okay. I get it, okay. The mini map is camera following means it will focus on where you're pressing left mouse button. So if we are in this AO, obviously nothing is going on. But if you are here and you press left mouse button, you don't even need left mouse button. You will get the information from the AO. I don't know why it's so. Okay, if you zoom in, it gets decluttered. So that's cool also, but I think which is the one that is helpful is basically in this case is the scenario minimap. Not sure if I will use it that often. I think we could go something like this. Now it looks really like some command center here. Yeah, they have some standard to be found. Okay, but it's fine. Because here you need to pull here. Here you need to can pull everywhere. Here you need to pull on this, on the header. But that's fine. It's okay. That's really peanuts. Really, the most important I see right now is get tech view in some sort of fog of war fashion. Perhaps it's already there and I can't see it in the demo. And I repeated the 10 times, if you know how to fix it, that I don't see enemy units on my map that aren't detected, tell it me please. And if it's not possible right now, I would even go for fading out, I don't know, all enemy units or whatever, simply to prevent. I get it. So if you zoom out, there's some special view, which is basically not shown in a demo, I guess. If you zoom in, it's fine. Okay. You can see the submarines here. Well, perhaps it's not a submarine, but here you can see ships. Type 91, is it a submarine? Yeah, that's simply not possible to use this tool. At least not for real time serious gameplay. Yeah, I guess they will fix it. I mean, Okay, speed up. Let's see how the game behaves on a bigger speed. Yeah, look at how fluid it is. I don't know what they met, what magic they put in, but look at this. It was impossible to play like this. It was impossible to play like this. The game would go into some sort of, I don't know, 3-4 seconds. Okay. Ah, let's check the balloons for the weapon settings. For the weapon messages. Let's see how this looks like. That's the balloon setting. I like it. Do we want to see a big screen? We basically can also play it like this now. I like it. You can really play command like this, at least watch like this. You can't give orders on this. The move object. Hello? Hello? Yeah, okay, I could remove, but yeah, it doesn't help. But I think there is some logic that I think they can fine-tune it. You know, there are some. Let's see if we can set a submarine. Yes. Oh, this is going so bright. If you go beneath the. Oh, jeez. Like some. Like some 3D editor. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, it's probably gone forever now. Okay. Can I continue? Yeah. Is the time speed working here? You need to jump from unit to unit. There's, I guess, at least for now, not no free view. It looks like the speed commands aren't working here on the screen. We have some cluttering here. No, I can't pause on the screen. But okay, that's fine. I mean, you want to watch it, I guess, in real time. Look at this. Holy Jesus! That looks good. What the hell? That's a bit loud. I like it. I think for the time being I will play it so late. Keep this, yeah, he keeps the camera angle for every unit. I think I will play it this way for the time being, because otherwise I don't want to cheat. At least we can see some eye candy without cheating. Yeah, I think that's fine. Damn it. I think this will change. So, take into account this game is some hours old, and it's a new for everybody. It's a new terrain for the free tech view guys, and this tool made a lot of progress. Yeah, it's beloved in the Flight Sim community. And Command also is it's new for them, and I guess they're working together. And yeah, I like it. This new, that's cool. Yeah, obviously helicopters aren't the best choice for anti-air. And the new sound is 10 times better. The new missile. Enemy missile sound is better. Yeah, we'll play this way for the time being, until they add the fog of war to it. Perhaps we can a bit shift the camera. I think that's fine, that's fine. That gives me some... Okay, why is it here so zoomed out? Ah, because the ship is so big. Mm-hmm. Okay, I get it. But I think this way we aren't able to cheat. Even if we... Sure, there's still the possibility to cheat. For example, if you have an ambiguity contact, yeah, which is dead, and you press on it, you can of course tell, is it over land or is it over water? For example, this plane here. Okay, we see nothing. That's interesting. Why we see nothing now? And because it's a buoy? What is... Is there some fog of war modeled? This helo here is going on a suicide mission. Interesting, this can also can't be selected. What is this? It isn't displayed here. Is it some, okay, that's interesting. I mean, it's a solid contact. Definitely here. Yeah, whatever. It's a complete new game, new mechanics, and it's not unusual that it requires some time to fine tune them, to polish them to the best extent. What's that for symbol? Okay, that's Zona Boy. Great picture. Yeah, I mean, I love it. That's the way how I will play it from now on. There's no going back for me, especially after using this map. There's no way. You see, we're running at full speed, and look at this. I don't know what they did. If it, it's basically, I don't know, 10 times faster than the regular Tsimano. Was never able to run it so fast and so fluid. You see the units aren't jumping on high time acceleration. They are still fluid, and your map is still fluid, everything is fluid, and you're running. Look at this, that's... I never reached, even in the smallest scenarios, and I think my command never reached this speed of time acceleration. You know, of course, it's the displays X64 or X128, but most times you never reached it. Even no matter what computer you had, and no matter how big the scenario was. I guess that's also the reason why they removed some of the settings, because they are not true. Yeah, I really like it. I think I will now finish the video. I will load my pictures into it. Get the new Shimano completed with my picture database, move it from my old install over, and then I think I will continue the Black Gold Blitz campaign scenario right in this new Shimano. So we can also get an idea about compatibility, but I don't see anything what should prevent it. Okay. Yeah, let's check out the manual. Perhaps it can us tell what. See the history update at the end of the manual. That is exactly what I was looking for. Let's pause it, otherwise I get a heart attack from... Yeah, exactly, that's important. You also now have personal factors in air combat, so there's G factor modeled in, and you can't turn, I don't know, 9G for minutes, because the pilot would suffer from it. Yeah, G-tolerance, pilot G-tolerance. Because in Shimano they are basically able to turn hard G's, to pull hard G's indefinitely, which is not their reality. Okay, seems they changed something about the logic of incoming fighters and interceptors. I like this, because these settings also change how the AI behaves. Doppler notching is simulated now. Here's some really advanced aspects of aircraft avionics are modeled. Aircraft can now roll and not simply change the direction or need to roll. Okay. Some better pathfinding. Better missile mechanics. Land units. Land cover type was added. We also have this overlay, so there is some information printed into the map. I'm telling how ground units how they will behave or receive damage. Land units can resupply. Realistic subcoms. When enabled, submarines who go below 40 meter depths go off the communications grid. The player can at any time send a ELF signal. Extremely low frequency. As these frequencies are able to penetrate even water, and these are often used by in order to inform submarines to come up to the surface in order to receive more detailed information. I'm not sure, I've read some stuff about ELF, how much information you can transmit with it. I think you can transmit some basic information. You can't transmit, I don't know, a love letter or something with it. It would take a lot of time. But you can translate, for example, I don't know, basic information like, yeah, come to the surface or whatever. So submarines come to the surface or raise their communications wire in order to receive more sophisticated information. And I like it. It's a setting. It's in Fleet Command you had something similar, but it didn't work that well, where submarines wouldn't you wouldn't have command over submarines that are going deep. And I like stuff like this, as you need to trust the AI more, with give him proper settings and whatever. Because with micromanaging you can always achieve a lot of success, of course. And you of course need to plan your moves ahead. So if you want to give, I don't know, a submarine an anti-submarine mission, you need to plan ahead. You can't move the movement marker around every 5 seconds in order to update your intent. I probably will play with it on. I like it. Open and build up terrain also has some big impact. Really good. Looks like they put a lot into the ground terrain in order to prepare for more detailed ground warfare. That's from NISA, the land cover we used. That's, I think, the new. And then that's the latest versions. That's the two databases they basically have purchased or have the license. That's database 3000 and Cold War database, I think. That's what I was talking about. That's like Google pictures for military assets. Obviously, they both don't cover every single version of every asset you can find in a game, but simply get the community update and you basically have almost all units covered. And if you like me and want to have complete pictures of when you're starting a scenario or even of your weapon systems, you can add it pretty quickly. All original scenarios have been remastered. Brand new scenarios by Paul Bridge, can I see them? The features. Ah, okay, that I was looking for. They are now in game, right? Yeah, okay, super. That's also good. That's really important. Because it was often difficult for scenario designers because they had to do several versions of a scenario, you know, because Chain of Wars has detailed aircraft damage. And they now added all of the DLC features into the main game. I think that's better. That's the way to go. Yeah, we can also check this out. It's not so interesting for me, but they added a quick battle mode. Let's check out the menu. You can go here and do a quick battle. And simply select the... Do you want to do a submarine duel, a surface duel? I guess more options will be added or can be added. You can select, I don't know, Australian ASV platform against a submarine. And how are the settings? And simply start to sandbox something. Perhaps that has something to do, the program informed me at the beginning that I have to disable Steam Direct Write. I'm not sure what this option is, but I think should give you some overview if you use it alongside other videos and official videos. And I like it. And that's my new standard. I can't go back. Command will become a big thing now. I mean, they really amped up the game, especially the presentation, because a lot of people about the controls and oh no, it looks like Windows, what is this? You sometimes read the Steam review, so it looks like some Windows screen, and yeah, you know. Sure, people always buy games without checking out what it is and expecting Fortnite or something, I don't know. But I think the new presentation will help, and it can't be bad. They have some serious military contracts going on, but it can only help if they will get, and especially help us who play war games for entertainment, that they will get more. They are popular. It's basically one of the most popular war games. But they will get now even more popular. So the name change, I like it, because the previous name, Command, Modern, Naval, Air, Land, whatever, Semano. This name is, I think, 10 times better. And CMO is a great abbreviation. And they still kept the old school name, that's cool. And yeah, I can fully recommend it and go for this version. There's nothing to be said, there's so much content, let alone the community scenario pack, and you have Steam Workshop, you have Matrix forums, it's full with content, and it's one of these games, if you want to play all scenarios, you would probably die before you finish them all. Especially the community pack comes with, it's a very well maintained community pack, and again, Northern Fury, for itself alone is so much missions in a Cold War setting. I hope they will continue to do some campaigns. What I sometimes miss, they do stuff like Shifting Sands and what's the other called? Desert Storm and Chain of Wars. But I feel some the missions. It's a personal thing of me. I know there are people they are completely fine to play. I don't know, mission one they play. I know day one of the war of the Desert Storm war. And scenario two is then day three. You're jumping into completely different setting. But for me, I like to have connected scenarios like Northern Fury. Northern Fury is, for example, you have basically a timeline that's going on. Sure, you don't play the same units. It's also not the same AOs. Sometimes you are in Norway, then you are in Ireland and or on the western coast of the US. But there's a timeline going on. You have day one of the battle. You have day two of the battle. You can follow a basic plot. I would wish they would go for more, when it comes to their campaign settings, they go for more structured. It doesn't mean they should go exclusively for this, but I don't know. Either provide really big scenarios where you can, but it's difficult for the AI if you do one single scenario for 10 days. The AI, programming the AI would probably become hell, scripting and everything. But if you could do a campaign style, why don't do, I don't know, day one of the Arab war and do, I don't know, seven scenarios for the Israel side, day one of the war, day two of the war, and pick a operation or pick a specific part of this. I know, sure, they go for it. Some of these wars are extremely long, you can't pick every day of the war, and they go obviously for the most interesting engagements, but provide some, I don't know, some structure, some connection, some logic, not simply throwing together scenarios and different days. I would really like to, that's for example Chain of War was, yeah, it had some timeline going on. But also the scenarios where one time you are US, one time you are Chinese, one time you are, I don't know, North Korean or Japanese. And yeah, it would be of course cool, but that's, of course, that's if you had some sort of more comprehensive campaign with, I already talked about that, the live scenarios and command in general, they amped up, they really made their presentations so much better in the last years. I've started to play Black Gold Blitz, and you've seen there's a PDF with going on with newspapers, then you have a video. If they could integrate everything into a game, this would even maximize the effect of the content they created. I think there should be also somehow able to include a video player into the mission briefing screen or whatever, or different tabs. For tab, mission briefing, tab, news, yeah, news, and you press on it, then you get the news PDF, and I don't know, news, TV or whatever, you know, you get the idea. And one, and the most important thing to I kept for last, is really this tech view fog of war thing. I mean, not sure you can't, sure, for the after action analysis it's okay, you can see everything, but I think a lot of people want to use it in real time to get a more sophisticated idea of the what's going on. And if you are able to see all enemy units, sea, air and land, it's cheating and it's harming the gameplay, and it's of course limiting the tool. Sure, we found a solution by keeping the camera panned basically in a top-down position, but I think that's not the solution. But I think don't care too much about it. basically, perhaps the devs are already working on this, of the devs of SimCommand and TagView. I wouldn't be surprised that they're already figuring out a solution for this, and we will soon see one. So it's day one, but from what I've seen, I'm really impressed by this. And yeah, let's finish here and let's start Black Gold Blitz again. See you.